Because if my parents had told me there was a Santa, they would then have to have a second conversation around the time I was like 8 to 11, I don't know. And they would have to sit me down and say, you know how your whole life we've been telling you there's two old magic white men? One of them lives in the North Pole where, with elves. Reindeer makes presents all year, gives them to you once a year. The other one lives in heaven. He tortured his own son to death, and it's your fault! One of them's not real. You want to take a guess? You want to take a step? Be careful. One of them's real jealous. Doesn't have the greatest record in child murder either. Not exactly a spotless record. Yeah, yes. But I talk a lot of shit about Christianity. I think it's only fair to talk about all the things that it gave to me. Because it did give me a lot. I did, like, Christianity gave me a strong conviction to do the right thing. It gave me sexual anxiety. Right. It gave me social anxiety. It gave me regular anxiety. It gave me my love of music. Depression, Stockholm Syndrome. Trauma, the list goes on and on. Listen, my cup runneth over. Blessed and highly favored. anybody else here grow up religious, Christian, any kind of religion? Who here grew up believing in a religion of some sort? Keep your hand up if you still believe in it. Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Oh, that's the devil right there. Oh, okay. That was fun. Like all the things Christianity gave to me. Oh, that one killed. The crowd work, that was okay. Well, I do not miss the South. I grew up in the South. I grew up independent Baptist in the South. And you might be thinking, you grew up Southern Baptist? Absolutely fucking not. Okay, we're nothing like those. We believed in autonomy of the local church. And everything else was pretty much identical to the Southern Baptist. But I don't miss the South. I'm not crazy about, I got people there I love, but I don't miss the place. Last time I was there, I was at a bar. I overheard someone in the bar say, "No way, dude, that's gay." Didn't know the context, didn't need to. I was taken aback. I was like, who's still doing this? Are we still doing this? Like, who is using gay to describe something as bad? What is your experience with gay culture? My experience has been nothing but a fantastic, fabulous improvement on culture. Like, it just doesn't make sense as an insult. Like, your shirt looks gay, bro. Thank you, it was expensive. You look gay today, bro. Thank you. I woke up early and invested in my own appearance. This movie's gay, bro. Thank you. We just won the Oscar over the musical because the musical wasn't gay enough. I'm really sensitive about that shit because I feel guilty about growing up very homophobic. Me and all my friends called everything gay. We acted like kissing a dude would be the worst thing that could happen to us. And yet we were also always posing these ridiculous hypotheticals with each other. We were like,
how much money would it take for you to suck a dick?
No, well, are you saving up? No,
I would suck a dick for $1 million,
which is something I said at once when I was younger. I wouldn't suck a dick for $1 million. $1 million! Now I'm $1 million? I would suck a dick right now for the curiosity of it. I gotta be honest with you, I'm disappointed. I'm let down. I'm downright put off by Hollywood. And I have been since 2003. And I'll tell you why. Maybe you know, maybe you forgot.
Forgot.
In 2003, a sequel to the film The Fast and the Furious came out.
Oh, yes!
Were you here the last time I did this?
No, I wasn't.
Oh, buckle up! but generally when a sequel would come out, they would call it the same name as its predecessor, followed by the number two. When the sequel to The Fast and the Furious came out in 2003, they called it Too Fast, Too Furious. Yes! Changed the landscape of Hollywood sequel titles. It was a game changer and everyone missed it. And it's not, I mean, because Hollywood is full of cowards and fools. But it's not like the Fast and the franchise is the Fast and the franchise. Jesus. It's not like they're blameless, because by the time the fourth movie came out, they'd already dropped it completely. They called the fourth movie The Fast and the Furious 4, when it clearly should have been called The Fast and the Furious. Just thinking about it. They slightly redeemed themselves when the eighth film came out and they called it The Fate of the Furious. Okay, thank you. Thank you. But think about it. What movie franchise doesn't immediately benefit by falling into this structure, right? Like Home Alone, Two Homes, Still Two Alone. Home Alone 3, Tokyo Drift. Home Alone 4, Forever Alone. This is the gritty reboot we get like 15 years later, where Macaulay Culkin's jacked, he's gained 50 pounds of muscles, he's got a huge beard, he's living in a cabin in the woods alone, chopping too much firewood for one person, just riddled with PTSD. And Marv and Harry finally make it out of prison, where they made a lot of friends, and they start a gang called the Bloody Bandits. They track Kevin down. They surround him. There's enemies on every side. Kevin! But he does what he does best and murders the fuck out of them with his booby traps. I would say he, like, grittifies them up, but he used a flamethrower in the second film. Home Alone 4, Forever Alone. Incredible film. Works with a lot of genres, too. Like, something completely different. Call Me By Your Name. To Call Us By Our Names. Call 3 By My Name, Tokyo Drift. Call Me By 4 Names, none of which are mine. Call Me 5 By Name, Freaky Friday Edition. 5 different couples get Freaky Friday into each other's bodies, all still trying to call each other by the other one's name! Hijinks ensue! Only 5 By Name, Freaky Friday Edition, incredible film. Titanic? Two-tanic? Tri-tanic? Titan-iv? Tricky one, IV, it's an IV again. Yeah, okay. 5-tanic? Titan-6? The Curse of the 6 Titanics? Titanic? Which is just Titanic, followed by 7 Seas. 7 Seas! Oh. Layers to that joke. Titan-Oc, or Octanic, or The Unexpected Virtue of Ignorance. 9-tanic, which is the one where the Germans build 9 Titanics that can form into 1 German Megatron monster robot. They're taking over the world, and they're only able to be stopped by a giant Robocop created by the frozen body of the corpse of Leonardo DiCaprio. 9-tanic, incredible film. And finally, Titanic. Right? You're right to applaud. The truth is, when I came up with that joke, I wrote Titanic first. And then realized I had to write 9 more jokes. But I'm glad I did, because it is about the journey, the destination. Especially when it comes to the Titanic!